Teachers so much because I basically grow up with all of you. We are a family and we have gone through a lot being together for the last few years. I have had a lot of good memories at the school, for example. When I miss being at school, getting in trouble, getting yelled at. Well, not really, but I will miss the moments when we all came together like a family and did what we had to do to succeed. This ceremony means that we have made it closer to our future. We took on a lot of obstacles this year and we still made it. This means that nobody in this class will say I can't do it because we did it while the worst things were happening. I can't wait to see what the future holds because I know we all want to be something great. You might not feel that now, but I know that we all want to be great. If we get a chance to reunite, I hope we still have this family bond. Can't wait to see all of y'all in the next 4 years. We hope you enjoy our virtual ceremony that celebrates our accomplishments we made throughout the elementary school years.
Hello, class of 2020, also known as my eighth graders. This has been a great past 2 years as your seventh and now eighth grade teacher. I have gotten an opportunity to get to know each and every one of you, and I have to say that it has been a pleasure. I'd like to take the time right now to wish you all the luck in the world in high school and beyond. When times get tough, don't make excuses. You know I'm big on that. Just remember all the lectures I gave you. You can do it. You are smart. You are very much capable. And don't ever let anyone tell you that you're not. You will go on to do great things. Be a leader. And most of all, be yourself. Being yourself means you're being original. And being an original is always worth more than a copy. Congratulations.
Dear graduates, class of 2020, you have the freedom to define who you are, find your passion, your every goal that has ever been reached. Begin with one step, which is you. When the road becomes hard to travel and it feels as if you never reach the end, look deep inside yourself and you will find strength you never had. Keep believing in yourself, and remember that dreams really come true. Congratulations to all William H. Brown graduates.
Congratulations to all the graduating Blazers from William H. Brown STEM School 2020. I wish everyone the best of luck in high school. We've had a very challenging year, but you've made it through it. These challenges will continue in your life, but you must remember this experience as a time that you overcame and were able to still succeed. Good luck again.
Congratulations to my 2020 graduates. I wish you guys the best of luck in high school. Take your time, do your best, stay focused, just do what you got to do. Ryan, I wish you the best, my son. Yo, Dyson really gonna miss you. Love you guys, Ms. Dyson.
Good morning and hello to the class of 2020. Natavion Meeks, Brian Valentin, and Dustin Ivy. Wow, I am so proud of you guys. Graduation is a successful ending and exciting beginning. Keep on dreaming. Keep on doing your best. Continue to keep up the good work as you reach for your goals. As I cherish the memories, I will miss you all dearly. Prayers and blessings to you on your new journey. Stay safe and take care. Ms. Harris.
Yo, what's up? This is Mr. Houston here. William H. Brown, class of 2020. Y'all did it. Listen, though. It takes a special type of person to be able to succeed throughout adversity. We are in different times right now, and you are a class that will never be forgotten. So I just want to take the time out to say congratulations, class of 2020. Stay motivated. Don't ever let nobody tell you that you can't do something, because you can. You just did the biggest thing that you could ever do possibly in life. You fought through adversity.
Brown School class of 2020. This is Miss Troop. I get teary-eyed around graduation time because I have watched you grow up. Young ladies and young men, we love you. We wish you the best. Please do your best in high school. Brown should not be your last dance. Keep making your moves through high school and even college. Congratulations on your graduation. Your lives truly matter. Peace be with you always.
Hello, everyone, my eighth grade class. This is Ms. Morris, and I am just elated. I am thrilled. I am so happy that this time has come where you graduate away from me. We've been together for 5 whole years. Remember fourth grade? Remember fourth grade? Well, I wish you the best in life, knowing that you can do whatever it is that you want to do. Whatever you want to achieve, you can do it. And I just want to make sure that I am available. You can come back anytime if you need anything, as usual. I want to say I love everyone and do well in high school, okay?
To the class of 2020, we are so proud of your accomplishments. You have overcome challenges with strength and determination. You are beautiful, confident, and driven. Enjoy this next chapter in your life. We love you so much.
Congratulations, class of 2020. May the world meet you at your feet. Good luck on your future endeavors. And personally, from me to you, I wish each and every one of you well. Congratulations.
Congratulations, William Brown, class of 2020. As you celebrate this first milestone, I want to wish you happiness, blessings, and prosperity as you enter high school. Remember to shine bright. Pull out all of your tools that we have given you so that you can have a successful high school year and graduate in 2024. I wish you well, Mrs. Ward. Thank you.
speaking to you today as Class of 2020 valedictorian. This is an honor I do not take lightly, and I didn't earn without the support of my dearest principal, Ms. Linus, teachers, staff, parents, and my fellow graduates. Today we are celebrating the success of the benefits you gained of our elementary education and the beginning of the new chapter in life. I know that all of us have mixed emotions, but this is the time to rejoice because we were able to finish and accomplish something that we can be proud of. Despite the many challenges we've experienced this school year, on behalf of my fellow graduates, I would like to take this opportunity to thank dear Lord and those who have helped us succeed, especially my family, friends, and peers. I steadily reminisce on some memories with my classmates, friends, and teachers. These are the things that we have laughed and shared at, even those that caused our so-called failures. We were in math class. We had problems to do on our own. Everyone finished the problem. Almost everybody had the same answer, except me and Ms. Matthew. So when Matthew showed her work, and I had a different answer from her, I showed her work, and I was right. Everyone was saying, I had that answer before I changed my answer. When I did the work and seeing everyone had the same answer, I got nervous, but I also had confidence that I was right. The moral of the story is do not be afraid to be different when you see everyone is the same, because you can succeed. These situations are too many to mention, but deep inside, I believe all of you know what I may have been thinking about. All of you cherish these unforgettable moments and experiences. I am reminded of a time I twisted my ankle. I was so hurt, but when we had basketball practice a day after, I felt like I had to miss practice. But Coach Stapleton told me not to give up and work hard, because there's someone out there that's in the same predicament that's working harder than me. I took his advice, but I still felt I couldn't do it. So what I did was take all negative thoughts out of my head and bring positive thoughts. Best believe, I pushed through and had a great practice. I want to share this with you. If you ever get into a situation where you think you can't do something, I want you to always think positively, because negativity always brings a person down. Persevere, stay confident, and always believe in yourself. Now that society may have considered us as grown-ups, I hope that we thank God and ask for His guidance. May we likewise instill values and lessons that we have learned in life and apply it to our high school years. Thank you to my fellow graduates. Congratulations, we did it.
Congratulations, William H. Brown, 8th grade 2020 graduates. I can't tell you how excited I am for you. So thankful that you have finally made it to the finish line, completed all your coursework, was able to endure COVID-19, and still you're on top. Ready to start high school in September? I couldn't be more proud. Please represent Brown well in all of your endeavors in high school. We love you. We're so excited for you. We wish the best for you. Have an enjoyable summer, and I look forward to seeing your grades first quarter when high school starts. Have a great summer. Go Brown.
Greetings, William H. Brown, graduates of 2020. We thank God for your success, especially during these difficult times. May your graduation be the beginning of many wonderful achievements in your life. Congratulations from your clerk, Mrs. Davis.
Congratulations. You're hurting you. You guys, all of you. You guys have taught me so much. Of course, I've been able to partner with you guys. That's a continued about me. Just reach me at Brown. And like I said, I'm just proud of you guys. And we want to see you guys. Graduate.
Congratulations.
Read of the hard that you have schoolwork. Leadership and throughout the time. All the best. And don't forget that's to 2020.
What's up, entry class of one man? I gotta say, guys, I'm hoping. I know it's been a last few courses, pandemic, knowing what to do. Daniel George Floyd. So I'm gonna say that that's your good push through going to be. Yeah, I just wanna say I'm like, you guys 2020. You guys are resilient because you guys have made it from home and just been every day with your little brothers, sisters, parents, just trying to figure out what to do without going crazy. But I just wanna tell you guys I'm extremely proud of you guys, and this is just the beginning. Just the beginning. Class of 2020, I can't wait for you guys coming back to visit Mr. Staples and saying, hey man, I'm graduating, I'm going to the University of Morehouse, Clark Atlanta, U of I, one of these universities, because you guys are so talented and so special. So I just want you guys to know I'm extremely proud of you guys. Class of 2020, work hard, stay focused, and there's nothing you guys cannot accomplish. Because you guys are a special group that will go down in history. Class of 2020 is a special group dealing with this pandemic and all this other stuff. So proud of you guys. Class of 2020. Woo-hoo!
Congratulations, class of 2020. This is Miss Williams. I just wanted to take time out to let you all know that I am extremely proud of each and every one of you all. I hate that the school year ended the way it did. However, I am so grateful and thankful to have met you all. I just wanted to let you all know that although this has been a challenging year, I am so proud of you all for sticking in there and finishing strong. Please go to high school and be the best students you all can be. Stay safe. Stay prayed up. Never lose focus. Despite everything that's going on, whatever it is, stay focused. It always gets greater later. So I pray that I can see you all soon. I love you and have a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful freshman year. Thank you.
moment we've all been waiting for. I declare that these eighth graders have met all graduation requirements. By the authority invested in me, by the state of Illinois, the city of Chicago, and the Chicago Board of Education, I hereby declare that these students are official graduates of William H. Brown STEM Magnet School and are hereby promoted to high school. Congratulations.
Congratulations to Class 2020. Your hard work has paid off. I salute you and your families for their dedication to your education, along with the principals of each school. Student, your future is in your hands as you move into a new direction. Know we here at the James R. Joy Foundation staff will continue to connect with you. I salute you.
Congratulations to the 8th grade graduating class of 2020. Congratulations to you, the family, friends, Brown School teachers and staff, and community members. You are who I call the village. You have helped each and every one of them get to this first milestone in their lives. I am LaToya Lyons, the principal of William H. Brown STEM Magnet School. This has been a year filled with change. These 25 graduates have undergone an 11-day teacher strike, an abrupt school closure due to COVID-19, learning new concepts through virtual teaching, and then you've also dealt with the political and social unrest of the unfair and unequal treatment of African Americans all across this country. Yet and still, you've remained committed and worked hard through the very end. I cannot tell you how proud I am to be your principal and to be the one to congratulate you on making and reaching this first milestone in your life of graduating the eighth grade. Today's graduation indicates your progress, your growth, and your transformation. When you graduate, it means you're a more mature being who is ready to start a new chapter in life. Benjamin Mays, a historical American civil rights leader, once said, "I've only just a minute, only 60 seconds in it. Forced upon me, can't refuse it, didn't seek it, didn't choose it. It's up to me to use it. I must suffer if I lose it, give an account if I abuse it. Just a tiny little minute, but eternity is in it." We kill time, we try to save time, we rob and get robbed of time. We lose time and we think we have all the time in the world. But no one of us is powerful enough to stop the march of time or slow it down. It is something far beyond our control. Today's message is simply strategies on how to make the most of the time you've been given here on earth. Number one, be bold, be courageous, and be your best. Your brothers and sisters, your cousins, and upcoming generations are looking forward to you making a difference today for their future tomorrows. With that said, we are in a time of social change. And with that being mindful, always advocate for yourselves when you believe firmly in something. Don't be afraid to speak your mind when you feel you are being mistreated or misunderstood. At all times, be your best selves in all you do. Number two, be flexible and keep your eyes on the learning goal prize. I can tell you now, you're going to have some struggles in high school. You're going to find out that you're in this big, huge school with more people and essentially making it easier for you to go unnoticed. You're going to start thinking you're grown just because you're getting older and maybe have a little more freedom. However, I recommend keeping your eyes on the prize. When grades drop, your eyes on the prize, you will seek help. When you get into a conflict with a peer, or even sometimes it's a teacher, keep your eyes on the prize. Seek resolution. When your home situation gets a little rough around the edges, keep your eyes on the prize. Get involved or seek college. And finally, step three, finish something. Nothing feels as good as finishing something to completion. Today should be the first of many milestones in your life. Eighth grade graduation is good, but high school graduation is even better. Completion of college or trade school is even greater than that. With that being said, do what is necessary to complete this next task, like maintain good grades, good attendance, and good conduct. These things will be crucial to your completion of high school and will open the door to your next place in life. In the words of Les Brown, accept responsibility for your life. Know that it is you who will get you to where you want to go, no one else. Congratulations to you on your success today. We are all counting on you to get to the next milestone, high school graduation. We are counting on you to do your best. We love you, and once again, congratulations to the graduating class of 2020.
We'll be right back.